What if you could take a complex physics animation that would normally take over 25 hours to render and finish the entire thing in just 2? Today, we are building an incredible animation from scratch in Tyflow. Welcome to the third video in our Vantage series. We're starting inside 3ds Max. And before we dive into the creative part, let's do something crucial. Organize our scene. Good organization is half the battle, especially with complex animations. We'll create separate layers for all the objects we want to animate: the chairs, the table, the lamp, and the decoration. We'll also create a dedicated layer for our Tyflow objects and helpers. All right, with our scene nice and tidy, create a Tyflow object from the standard primitives panel. Inside the Tyflow editor, we'll start with a birth operator. This is what brings our objects into the simulation. Let's select the chairs and the table and click Add Selected. Inside the Tyflow editor, you can press the Tab key and just type the name of the operator you need. We'll use a Move Pivots operator. Change its setting to On Shape Bounds Local and choose Bottom. Now, to make our objects appear from nothing, we add a scale operator, set it to absolute, and change the value to 0. So, how does the animation know when to start? We need to create a trigger. For this, we'll use an object test operator. We'll use a simple helper object. I'll create an arrow, but you can use anything you like. Let's animate this arrow. The animation will start when the arrow moves through our objects. So, the starting keyframe should be below the chairs. And I'll set the end keyframe at frame 120, with the arrow positioned above the chairs. Now, back in Tyflow, we'll select the arrow as our test object and set the condition to below object, local space, on the Z-axis. To make something happen when the trigger is activated, just drag from the object test bubble to create a new event. Everything in this new event will only happen after the arrow crosses our objects. Here, we'll add a speed operator. Choose a long icon arrow and create a new icon. Let's make it a bit bigger. We want the chairs to move up, so let's rotate the icon's arrow to point upwards. A magnitude of 0.2 centimeters should work fine for the speed. You might need to test a few values here to see what works best for your scene. Next, let's add another scale operator to make the objects grow to their full size. Set it to absolute. I'll use an interpolation of 0.4 and a variation of 50% to make the scaling feel a bit more organic. Right-click on the timing and set it to continuous. To make it look realistic and not just float away, we need some physics. Add a PhysX shape operator. This tells Tyflow our objects should have real-world physical properties. A dynamics restitution of 0.5 will give them a bit of bounce. Okay, that's looking good, but the speed might be a little high. Let's dial it back to 0.1. Perfect. Finally, add a PhysX collision operator and select the floor. Now, our objects will collide with it. And there we have it. The first part of our animation is ready. Now for the decoration. And here's the beauty of a node-based system. We don't have to build everything from scratch. First, we'll create a new birth operator for the decoration objects. Then, simply hold Shift and drag the operators one by one from our first animation. Move pivots, scale, and object test. We want the decoration to appear after the chairs and table are animated. To do this, we'll duplicate our animated arrow and simply offset its keyframes in the timeline. Easy. Now, let's create the second event for the decoration and copy over the speed, scale, and PhysX operators.
Make sure to add the new arrow to the object test.
Depending on your objects, PhysX can sometimes behave unexpectedly. To prevent weird rotations, you can always lock the position or rotation axes. I'll lock them, as I only need movement on the Z axis for this. One last crucial setting. In the main Tyflow settings, change the time step to 1/2 frame for a more accurate physics simulation. For the lamp, we'll use a more traditional approach instead of Tyflow. First, adjust the lamp's pivot point so it's at the very top, where it would hang from the ceiling. Now, activate Auto Key. Go to frame 100 and scale the lamp down to 0. 3ds Max automatically creates the animation. Now just drag the first keyframe past the second one. And voila, the lamp now grows into the scene. Before we can render, there's one super important step in Tyflow. At the very end of both of your events, add a mesh operator. This ensures that Vantage can actually see and render the objects from Tyflow. Also, inside your birth operators, make sure instance material is set to inherit from object. Okay, the animation is ready to be rendered. As always, set your render engine to V-Ray GPU and run the scene converter. Now, here's the key difference from our last video. We can't export a Tyflow animation directly. Instead, we'll use the powerful Live Link. This means we need to set up our lighting and environment here. I'll adjust the V-Ray sun, setting the intensity to 3.0 and the size to 0.5 for softer shadows. I'll also use the CIE overcast sky model. Then, I'll create a V-Ray sky in the environment slot, linking it to our sun.
Inside the V-Ray sky, I will also use the CIE overcast sky model and adjust the intensity to 0.35. Under rendering, open the environment tab and use the created V-Ray sky as environment map. Perfect. Now, make sure you've selected the correct camera in your viewport and lock it in the render setup.
It's time to connect the two worlds. Press Start Live Link and wait for Chaos Vantage to open. Inside Vantage, I'll quickly adjust the color correction and save it as a new substate. If you want a deep dive on this, check out the previous animation tutorial. I'll also create a new scene state that includes these color settings. The best part about Live Link is that you can now scrub the timeline in 3ds Max and see the complex Tyflow animation update in real time in Vantage. It's incredible for previewing your work. Finally, I'll adjust my render settings. I won't go into detail here since we have a separate video on that. To start the render, go back to 3ds Max and hit Render Animation with Chaos Vantage.
This opens the render dialog in Vantage. Choose the animation state we just created. Make sure to deactivate Reduce Flickering for this workflow, and select the correct frame range. Then save as PNG and hit render. And the render is off. This whole animation will take me about 2 hours. Now, think about this. Using a traditional renderer like Corona would take around 10 minutes per frame. For 150 frames, that's a 25-hour render job. The time saving here is just incredible. And that's it. You've successfully created your first Tyflow animation from scratch and rendered it via Live Link in Chaos Vantage. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.